In this problem, we're asked to select the set that best describes the numbers given here below. And our choices are real, imaginary, or a complex number. So let's start with a quick review. Complex numbers, or numbers in the form of a plus bi, are made up of the set of real numbers and imaginary numbers. So when we think of a complex number, we can think of it having two parts. A represents the real part of the complex number, and bi represents the imaginary part of the complex number. Remember, where I is equal to the square root of negative 1. So if we have a complex number where b is equal to 0, it would not have an imaginary part, and therefore the complex number would be a real number. So all real numbers are complex numbers, but for all real numbers, b would be equal to 0. The other case would be if we have a complex number where the real part is equal to 0, or a is equal to 0, we would just have the imaginary part, or a number in the form of bi. And if this is the case, we can say that the complex number is also an imaginary number. So when it says select the set that best describes a number, all the numbers will be complex, but if we can say a number is a real number or imaginary number, these would be the sets that best describe the number because it provides more details about that number. Let's take a look at our examples. First, we have the number 6, which if we want to, we could think of this as 6 plus 0i. So it is a complex number, but since b is equal to 0, it's better to describe this as a real number. And again, even though all real numbers are complex numbers, by describing this as a real number, we're giving more information about the number. Next, we have 2 minus 7i. Notice how for this, we have a real part and imaginary part. So the set that best describes this number is that it's a complex number. And then for the last example, we have negative 2i, which if we wanted to, we could think of this as 0 minus 2i. So again, this is a complex number, but since a, the real part, is equal to 0, it's better to describe negative 2i as an imaginary number. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.